Most blissful way of living, most happiest way of living, without any difficulty, without experiencing any difficulty, is learn to be a student all the time. Learn to live life like a student. Everyone wants to be a master. Everyone wants to be a teacher. You join any WhatsApp group, you will know how everybody wants to teach others. This person wants to communicate something to the other, that fellow wants to say something to the other, and they say, why are you sending that? Wanting only to share. Can't be a student. You have to lecture, you have to teach. You can't be a student. You should know how to be a student. The moment you know how to be a student, you are in bliss. And last 1 month I was in that bliss. Ippo therivi most boring aspect of life has started. To sit on a pedestal and keep talking also. So boring it is. So useless also it is. Yes, so Nana, I have to justify, you know, 1 month holiday I took. Amen. So every week, of all the people, Venkata is on tension every week. Yeah, whether is there class or not, first question he will ask, sir, are you coming back? Any change in your future plans? I said, I don't know what plans I have. Presently plan illa. What is future plans? 1 month. Blissful life. Yeah. So when I was leaving, I was thinking, what am I? Why am I leaving? Go back and do what? You want to grow, learn to be a student. What is to be a student? Don't talk philosophy to anybody other than your own self. If you are doing that, you are a you are a student. If at all you want to talk philosophy, talk only to yourself. Don't talk to others. The other could be dying. Don't worry. Don't talk philosophy to others. If at all you want to talk, stand in front of the mirror and talk to yourself, or go to the bathroom and talk to yourself. But don't talk to others. But the natural tendency is to keep talking. At least I don't talk, sir. Unga recording da I keep sending. Yeah, don't even do that. Just receive and stay quiet. Don't talk. Because the more you talk, more you increase your memory. More the memory, more you believe. More the memory, more you have understood, more you think that you know. More you think you know, and all the knowing comes through the memory, because so much of knowing but no transformation. So much of knowing but there is no transformation means that you have not actually, it means you have not known anything. Surely I know that everyone sitting here can talk for minimum 1 hour non-stop. I know everyone sitting here, you given a platform now, you can speak for easily 1 hour minimum. சார் உங்களை கூட கொஞ்சம் நல்லாவே பேசுவோம், நீங்களாவது ரொம்ப போர் அடிக்கிறீங்க. அட்லீஸ்ட் வீ கேன் சே சம் மோர் ஸ்டோரிஸ், வி ஹேவ் பெட்டர் கோட்ஸ் தென் வென் யூ ஆர் அ ஸ்டூடெண்ட். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் இஸ் டூ நாட் ஸ்பீக், டூ நாட் ஷேர். Why you should not share now is because you yourself is only accumulating now. You yourself is only gathering now. When you yourself is gathering, how can you share? You share, but what happens is what? That's what has happened. I know people 20 years, 30 years, 50 years. Nothing has transformed, nothing has changed. So you talk to them, you know, they keep talking, sharing. Nothing is allowed to, you don't allow things to settle inside you. Because the law of life is this: you can give what you have, you can't give that which you do not have. You understand? You can give only what you have, you cannot give that which you do not have. You have sorrow and misery, you can only give sorrow and misery. A sorrowful person, a person living life in misery, cannot give bliss and joy to others. It's impossible. You live in misery, you will give misery only to others. You live in joy, you can give joy to others. Therefore, do not share. Simply stay quiet. Receive and stay quiet. But I want others also to benefit, no? So wonderful is the knowledge, so wonderful is this class, so wonderful is this. Everyone should benefit, no? Ask yourself, have you transformed? If you have transformed, the transformation will speak by itself. You don't have to make an effort. It will speak by itself. You have knowledge. People will come and take it from you. You don't have to go on வாட்ஸ்அப்ல யூ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் டு கீப் ஆன் ஷேரிங். சம் ட்ரங்கன் ஃபெலோ டைப்ஸ் டு சம்திங் அண்ட் தட் கெட் சர்க்குலேட்டட் த என்டையர் வேர்ல்ட். சி யூ கேன் டைப் வாட் எவர் யூ வாண்ட் அண்ட் தென் அட் த எண்ட் புட் ஐன்ஸ்டீன். ஹூ நோஸ் வெதர் ஐன்ஸ்டீன் எக்ஸெட்ரா ஆர் நாட். யூ கேன் டைப் வாட் எவர் யூ வாண்ட் அண்ட் தென் சே பகவத் கீதா. சம்டைம்ஸ் ஐ கேட் ஐ எம் வாண்டரிங் வேர் இஸ் இட் செட் இன் த பகவத் கீதா. யூ டைப் யுவர் ஓன் கீதா இன்ஸ்டெட் ஆஃப் சேயிங் மை கீதா யூ ஹேவ் டு சே பகவத் கீதா. டோன்ட் ஷேர். ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்டே குவைட். பட் இட் இஸ் சோ வேல்யூபிள் சார். அதர்ஸ் ஆல்சோ ஷுட் பெனிஃபிட். ஃபார் தட் ஓன்லி ஐ ஆம். ஐ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் த ஆட்டிடியூட் ஆஃப் டீச்சர் அண்ட் ஆல். ஃபார் த பெனிஃபிட் ஆஃப் அதர்ஸ் ஓன்லி ஐ வாண்ட் டு ஷேர். வாட் கேன் யூ ஆன்சர்? How do you answer yourself? I'm not talking about how you are going to answer others. How do you answer yourself? The only test is, with all this, have you transformed? If you have not transformed, you yourself are in doubt about this. When you yourself have doubt, do not share, because you yourself have no clarity. You yourself are in doubt. It is the doubt is there, which is hidden, but you can't see it. The doubt is there, which is hidden, you can't see it. That's where, with so much, you know, there is no transformation, because fundamentally there is a doubt. Second thing, you have knowledge. Wait for people to approach you. They will come. Actually, you don't have to wait and all. They will come and they will approach. Yeah. Abu Dhabi lendu kuda they will come and approach. Yeah. You have to come and approach from anywhere. They will approach. Actually speaking, from morning till night I was non-stop talking. From morning till night I was talking. That 1.5 hours that he speaks in the class is the only time I had a rest. So I thought, my God, better to be in Chennai. Leave the weekday, the one night of the holiday. Anga there is no constantly one after the. And they started making a mockery of me also. Yeah, they started making a joke out of me. Don't talk. Do not share. Do not talk. If you can do both, you are living the life of a student. You are living life of a... But you cannot. Why? Because you have not enjoyed the bliss of what it is to be a student. Only if you have tasted that bliss, you will not want to come out of it. You have not tasted that. No fault of you. You have not tasted what it is to be a student. What it is to sit at the feet of the master. What it is. Just simply. Just sit. That's all. What is there? Sit now. Don't come to my house, sir. I will be chased out of the house. Yeah, I am occupying someone else's house. Anga vandhalna I will be chased out. What is it? Blissful is to be a student. You become a student when the situation drives you into helplessness. When a situation in life drives you to helplessness, at that point of time you become a student, meaning you are willing to take advice, you are willing to take guidance. Only when you are driven to that corner. Otherwise rest of the time you are giving discourses to everyone. That's not being a student. It is a situation that drives you. So when a situation drives you, you are more interested in looking for a solution to the situation rather than any learning. That's where Ramana says, you will come to an enlightened master and you will not know what to ask him, he said. You will go to an enlightened master and you will not know what to ask him. And you will go and ask him all the wrong things, all the wrong questions you will ask. And you go to the master, you don't ask any question. You go and tell him and say, please say whatever you have to say. And he says, you are ignorant, get rid of the ignorance that you will not like to hear. Now you go to the master and say, please tell me what I should do. He says, you are ignorant now. Get rid of your ignorance. How can you accept that you are ignorant? How can you agree that you are ignorant? And the fact is, you are ignorant. The fact is, you are ignorant. Therefore, a person who has understood his ignorance keeps quiet. He will not talk. The person who has understood his ignorance will not talk. See, when I say he will not talk, he will talk about politics, he will talk about movies, he will talk about Kabali teaser. Everything else he will talk, except you ask anything on philosophy, he immediately he goes into the, he says, this subject let us not talk. You are being a student. But otherwise you want to talk about this all the time, you miss being a student. If you have missed being a student, you can never learn. But because of the memory capacity, you go on storing that information, and the stored information make you to believe you know. The stored information make you to believe you know. What is the proof that you have known? What is the proof that you have known? That you have grown? That you have transformed? There is only one proof. There is only one proof. And the proof is this. You tell your mind to stay in a place, if it has to stay. If it is not staying, now you have not grown, full stop. That's all. You tell your mind, stay in the class, it should stay in the class. You tell your mind, stay on the IPL, it should stay. Then you have grown. But it doesn't happen. You tell your mind, stay here, it will say, I will not. Who are you to tell me? So something inside you is doing what? Something inside you is doing what it wants to do, and you have no control on that. You have absolutely no control on that. It goes everywhere except the place where you tell the mind be. In the class you will think about everything else. When you are doing something else, you will be thinking about the class. Doesn't matter. The mind doesn't stay. If the mind is not staying where you tell the mind to stay, you have not grown. You have not transformed. You have not. You can do what? You can give a fantastic discourse. You can do whatever you want to, you can do. But it doesn't stay. To do that, the starting point is to be a student. Receive the knowledge, reflect on it, digest it and keep it. Digest it and just keep it. Don't talk about it. Because the moment you talk, you have lost it. The moment you talk, you have lost it. It's like you are not allowing yourself to become rich. You get some money, you immediately spend it. You get some money, you immediately spend it. Memory tells you what? So much of money you have got. But look at you, there is nothing. Your memory tells you that you have got so much of money. But one look at you, you know there is no. Why? Because you don't allow it to stay. You don't allow it to grow. You simply spend it. You simply do not spend it. Keep it. To do that, taste the bliss of being a student. And so blissful it is to be a student. So blissful it is to be a justification. Why classes were not being held for 1 month indrathukku some justification. Avladhaan. Don't take it seriously. Don't take it seriously. You want to be some justification he gave for 1 month of no classes. The subject matter for 1 month was on God. The subject matter for 1 month is God. Thesis on God. Nothing happened because of that. What is God? What or who are we? Don't know. Clear. What is God or who is? Who is God? Is there anyone who wants God? No one. No one wants God. When you say you want God, you don't want God. You want God because you think God will solve your domestic problems. Clear? God will come and take care of cat. Who wants? No one. The intensity with which you want money, the intensity with which you want name, the intensity with which you want fame, the intensity with which you want others to respect you, the intensity with which you want others to honor you. Of that, not even 1% intensity is towards God. And to that group, what you can talk on God? And yet he spoke to us for 1 month. I'm not talking about you all. I was talking about myself there. And to such a group, he spoke on 1 month. On what is God? You can't have the world and have God. Either you have the world or you have God. Both are not possible. It's not possible to have both. Because reality and unreality cannot coexist. Either you live in unreality or you live in reality. Reality and unreality cannot coexist. It's the fundamental principle. What is God? What is the nature of God? In order to know God, you have to know what the world is, and the world that you know is an illusion. The world that you know is an illusion, and beyond this illusion lies God. Sir, it is already telling, sir, இதுக்கு ஒரு மாசம் யூ சாட் தேர் டு ரீட் திஸ் வி நோ, திஸ் வி நோ ஆல்ரெடி, வாட் இஸ் வேர்ல்ட் வி நோ ஆல்ரெடி, வாட் இஸ் இல்யூஷன் வி நோ ஆல்ரெடி, அண்ட் பியாண்ட் திஸ் இல்யூஷன் லைஃப் காட், திஸ் வி நோ ஆல்ரெடி. யூ ஜஸ்ட் வாண்டட் டு ரன் அவே ஃப்ரம் அஸ் ஃபார் ஒன் மந்த், யூ வென்ட். காட் எல்லாம் சும்மா எக்ஸ்கியூஸ், அவ்வளோதான். அவங்க எக்ஸ்கியூஸ் யூ நீட் த வேர்ல்ட் தட் யூ நோ. வாட் இஸ் த வேர்ல்ட்? What is the world that you know? What is the nature of the world? The nature of the world is change. What is the nature of the world that you know? Changing. Changing into what? What is the nature of change? It's changing. What is the change? Change, which is not permanent, unpredictable. What is the nature of the world? It's unpredictable, it's changing, it's impermanent. Changing into what? Nama Rupa. He stayed for 3 weeks, Adhanalapa. Paavam, they finished him off. I don't think he will come again. Gang potukittu, they finished him off. Illa Manohar? I didn't go there at all. I didn't, because I know what they are up to. So I didn't go anywhere near him for 3 weeks. Last day he was almost crying. Now, Uttrunga sir, I will not come back. I will not come back to this place again. So Nama Rupa. It's changing. Changing into what? What is the change? How you experience it? How you think? Full discourse with it. Yeah, it's a complete discourse. Ippadhaan, don't give discourse. What is the world that you change? What is the change that you are experiencing? The change that you are experiencing is the constant movement, the constant change into dash. What is that? What is that? Opposites. What is the change? 2 hours back it is 3 hours back it was dark. Now it is light. Sometime later it's going to be dark. Sometime later it's going to be light again. What is the change? Pairs of opposites. The change that you experience is nothing but a constant movement of opposites. The change. What is the change? The change into opposites. From light to darkness, to light, to darkness, to light, to darkness. Is it okay? From birth to death, from birth to death, to birth to death, is the changes. Pairs of opposites. Idhu vaana sir. Light and darkness varaikum stop it. But don't talk about birth and death and all. Clear? Abba Sogunamma, don't say anything. Say something very, very good to hear. Birth and death. It's a change. But I agree that it is a change, but the change should happen according to, I agree with the changes, sir, but the change should happen according to my wish. Correct. The change I agree, but the change should not happen in the way that it wants. The change should happen in the way that I want. I know, sir, all beings are mortals. Everyone who is born will die. What is the difficulty in understanding that all beings are mortals? The moment there is a birth, the possibility of death has occurred. Only thing, sir, my children should die after me, not before me. Yeah? You want her? I'm not saying they will die. I also have a daughter. Huh? It's not that. But then there is a change doesn't bother you. The change that is not happening according to your whims and fancies, the changes that is not happening according to your likes and dislikes, bothers you, troubles you. Change doesn't bother you. Change not happening according to your likes and dislikes. And where do you gather these likes and dislikes from? How do you gather these likes and dislikes? How do you gather these likes and dislikes? Desires. Desires means likes and dislikes. Likes and dislikes, desires are synonymous. Where do you gather these likes and dislikes from? How do you gather these likes and dislikes? What makes you to run behind the likes and dislikes? A constant sense of unfulfillment. A constant sense of unfulfillment. You always feel something is missing, something is not there, all the time. Irrespective of what you have and what you don't have, the sense of unfulfillment doesn't leave. It is this sense of unfulfillment that drives you to run behind the world. You go on gathering likes and dislikes. Likes and dislikes is nothing but a vain hope for fulfillment. Desires is nothing but a vain hope for fulfillment. It's a vain hope. It's an illusory hope. Likes and dislikes is nothing but an illusory hope of happiness. An illusory hope of likes and illusory hope of fulfillment. It's illusion. You don't get it. You don't get it. If you have got it now, you all must be fulfilled. You all should be fulfilled by now. Because it's not that none of your desires got fulfilled. It's not that none of your desires is unfulfilled. Out of 100 desires, some desires have attained fruition. Out of your desires, some desires of yours have attained fulfillment. What has happened to you now because of that fulfillment? What has happened to you now? Nothing has happened. It means what? It means what? It means what? It's hopeless, it's useless to look for fulfillment through desires, likes and dislikes. Then you have the courage to drop them. Then you have the courage to drop your desires. Then you have your courage to drop the likes and dislikes. And when you drop them, those who have attained the self, those who have attained the state of enlightenment, they tell us that once you have dropped your likes and dislikes, what remains is bliss. What remains is God. That aspect we cannot understand. But one thing you can understand, what? All your desires till now that has found fulfillment has not made any change in you. Now, on what basis are you hoping that your future fulfillment will give you the future fulfillment will give you that bliss? This is thinking. You don't think. This is thinking. You follow what I am saying? It's not that none of your desires, if all your desires have not found any fulfillment, na, we all will be insane by now. We all will be insane by now. Too much of suppression, too much of frustration. Out of 10 desires, at least 5-6 have attained fruition. At least 5-6 have attained fulfillment. But that desires being satisfied has not created any change in what? Any change to? Any change? As a fulfillment. There is no fulfillment. That unfulfillment is still continuing. So how much ever your desires are fulfilled, even if Krishna were to come and give you a darshan, you will still remain unfulfilled only, because the mind will say, okay, now why not try some other? Go on. You understand? You follow? Since none of the desires that has found fulfillment has not brought in fulfillment to you. You want to buy a car. You buy a car. But unfulfillment remains the same. You want to buy a house. You buy a house. Unfulfillment still remains. You want a family. You get a family. Lovely family, sir. But still something is missing. Lovely family. But still something is missing. Like a pickle, you want one guru also. To find? So you get, go there. There also you don't find? So right through your desires found its fulfillment, but you don't experience fulfillment. You follow? Desires finds its fulfillment, but inside you don't experience any fulfillment at all. So, first thing, before knowing God, first thing is to understand what? The root of this unfulfillment. Having found the root of this unfulfillment, you try and eliminate it. When you have eliminated it completely, you reach a state of bliss, fulfillment, contentment, satisfaction. Whatever word you want to use, you use, doesn't matter. Relatively speaking, learn this. Relatively speaking, that all your growth, all your aspirations, all your goals, all your understandings, all your higher goals that you have in life, all the higher ideals that you have in life, arises from a deep sense of discontentment. You do not know how to grow out of contentment. You do not know that. You can hear it a million times, but still you will not know how to grow out of contentment. All your growth comes from what? Discontentment. It means, if you sow the seed of discontentment, you can never reap the fruit of contentment. It's against the law. It's against the law of causation. You sow the seed of discontentment, what you will reap? Discontentment only. Desires will find its fruition. Desires will find its fulfillment. But you will still be discontented. Why? Because what you have sown? Discontentment. The moment you talk about contentment, you do not know what to do after that. the moment you talk about contentment, you will not know what to do. And then you say, but contentment aranda, see sir, how will life grow? Will all the scientific advancement happens out of the, if everyone was contented, will any discovery happens? Will any invention happens? It means you have not learnt anything about the world only. Forget about God. You have not learnt anything about the world. A man who discovered the bulb didn't have any vision of lighting up the whole world. You know that, no? A man who discovered the bulb didn't have any vision of lighting up the entire world. He said, I want to do what I want to discover a bulb, that's it. Contentment, that's all. That's all that is. What is contentment means? You follow what I am saying carefully. You miss it. When he discovered that bulb, it was out of contentment. What is contentment here means, you ask him, okay, after discovering the bulb, what will you do with the discovery? Thank God he didn't come and ask any one of us. We will give him fantastic ideas of how to encache it. Correct. And that's the right word. Your pair enna? Venkata Subramaniam. Vada. Encache it. That is discontentment. That is discontentment. Correct. Wanting to quickly encache it. You go and study in the university. You want to encash it. What is the salary I will get? You sell yourself for? You sell yourself. And you are not ashamed also. You are not ashamed. You take pride also in that. Some fellow gives 100 rupees more, you transfer. And you take pride in that. Discontentment it is. You can move from one to the other. What will happen? Discontentment remains. Anything worthwhile that happens in the world, the starting point is contentment. What is contentment means? No idea of how it is going to be encashed. Trade. A trading mentality. Everything is only a trade. That's all. Contentment is what? That's what that painter wrote. Everybody comes and asks me, why are you painting? He says, that question irritates me. Why are you painting? You can't even understand why that man is getting irritated. He can't understand. Why are you asking that question? We do not know how to grow out of contentment. We do not know that. All our growth is based on discontentment. And any you sow the seed of discontentment, you will reap. You sow the seed of discontentment, what you reap? More discontentment, correct. You sow one mango seed, you get millions of mangoes out of that. No. One seed of discontentment you sow, you reap? The tree of discontentment. The 15th chapter of the Gita, he says, cut the tree, Arjuna. You have made a huge and what tree? Not ordinary tree. Ashwatthamenam suvirudamulam asangashastrena dridena chitva. It's not ordinary tree, Arjuna. It is that Ashwatha tree. You know what is an Ashwatha tree, no? What is an Ashwatha tree? What is it called in English? People tree. Huge. 100 horses can be? 100 horses. It's called Ashwatha because hundreds of horses rest under the tree. Now, how huge is that? Many branched.
Many branched is the tree. And all came from? All the huge tree came from? One seed of discontentment you sow. Don't worry. Yeah, be happy. Yeah, don't be happy. You will reap the... And when you are reaping the tree, you go back complaining. What? You go back saying what? Life has cheated me, sir. But I don't deserve to be treated like this. You also cheated me. Yeah. The seed of discontentment you sow, you reap. What do you reap? The tree. And don't get lost. At least you have the capacity to cut the tree. Yes, cut the tree. You have the sword in your hand. Even though you have a huge tree with all his affection and love and grace, the divinity has given us the sword to cut the tree. What is that sword? What is that axe? What is that axe? Axe of detachment. That huge tree can be cut by that axe. What is that axe? Acts of detachment. Detachment. Vairagya. Renunciation. Which is knowledge? That is knowledge. Otherwise, it's only information. We all have so much of knowledge, but this knowledge has not resulted in any vairagya, which is what we keep saying. There is no transformation. There is no transformation. There is no transformation. Transformation means what? Yours? What does the transformation means? Your vairagya increases. Your detachment increases. Your ability to be objective increases. And that is the tree. That is the axe. Cut the tree. Verse number 2, chapter 15. He says, Ashvattamenam suvirudamulam ashangashastrena dridena jitva dridam. That ashanga must be with full of determination. Now our detachment doesn't have any determination. Clear? One mobile battery going down is enough to disturb. Clear? Mobile battery going down is enough to bring all the worries and anxieties back. Where is the determination? In what? In vairagya. And what is vairagya? Raga means, if you use one, the opposite is included. In philosophy, at least understand this. If one is said, the opposite is included. So when he talks about raga, what is included in that? Dvesha. So raga and dvesha, likes and dislikes. The Sanskrit word vai means enemy. That's where vairi we say. Orthodox people still use the word vairi. Vairi means parambara vairi, sir. Means what? They are enemies for generations. One drunken man fought with another drunken man. They are still fighting. Vairi. Vairi means enemy. Vairagya is this. The capacity in you to see the likes and dislikes inside you as your enemies. That capacity in you where you can understand that the likes and dislikes sitting inside you is your enemies that is bringing your downfall. As a result of which, you want to get detached from that. As a result of this understanding, you get detached from that. As long as you think likes and dislikes are very important to live life, you can never get. Don't worry. Yeah, you will be a very good professor of philosophy, all of that. Be a very good professor, but no transformation. But then life na konjamaadu get detached na, you will say, but some attachment is required, no? Minimum attachment is required, no? One seed of discontentment, that's all. And when you are reaping the fruit of agony, pain, sorrow, don't blame the world, because you have sown and you are reaping. Yeah. Where all I have sown, can I know that, sir? So that I can go and dig it out, huh? Where all I have sown, please tell me now, sir, so that I can quickly go and cut it. Regression தான் போனோம் இல்லையா. Even that fellow also will not know what to, where you have, how will you yourself don't know where you have sown, how will others know? If you do not know your ignorance, how will others know? Where all you have sown? The areas of where you have sown is only very few. In fact, it's only two. Wealth, relationships. That's all. All your seeds of discontentment are sown only in two areas. One is wealth. Another is relationships. You have never sown even a single seed of discontentment for God. You have not even sown one seed of discontentment in relation to God. All the seeds of discontentment you have sown only in relationship to wealth and relationships. Wealth and relationships is the most useless thing, because now connected to the very starting point. It's the changing factor. It's the moving factor. And the changing factor changes according to a master plan, not according to, see, all the changes occurs according to some master plan. Whatever plan you do, it's not going to change. The best laid plans of men and mice gang off the ugly, he says. The best laid plans of men and mice gang of aglena, chipram hi manushe, in a second the whole complexion changes, not to retrieve back at all. Doesn't come back at all. The whole thing changes in a second. Knowledge prepares you for that. When you are prepared through knowledge and understanding, you develop a disinterest in the world. When you have developed a disinterest in the world, correspondingly you will develop interest in the Supreme Reality. You can't have interest in the world and interest in Supreme. Both doesn't go together, either here or there. Ramtirtha says, you can't travel in two boats at the same time. And boats are travelling in the opposite direction. At least one direction of one alone will be enough. Like you can stand on two motorcycles and go, no? When both are moving in the same direction, how can you stand when both are moving in opposite direction? And you are trying that, you will break your bones. Nothing will change. You follow? So you have sown seeds of discontentment. What are the areas where you have sown seeds of discontentment? wealth and relationship. If something has to be done to you, nothing has to be done to you. Touch your wealth, touch your relationship, something happens inside. Clear? Very few people, honestly, they say. See, when you really experience a pain, nothing happens here. If you are in real pain, if you are real sorrow, something happens here, no? Have you ever I know everyone have experienced it many a times. Correct? Nothing happens here. Something happens here. The whole foundation is shaken. Because you have sown seeds of discontentment there. Buddha has sown seed of discontentment elsewhere. Where? About God. Wanting to know what God is. Ready to risk at least one lifetime. Anyway you have many, many lives. I was telling that boy the other day. Anyway you have many lives too. So at least one lifetime. Risk for God. No, anyway every life is a loss making business. Every life that you go through is a loss making business. It's a loss making business, that's all. What do you carry except your agonies and sorrows? Nothing. It's a loss making, no. At least if something comes with you, that's what they tried. In the Egyptian mummies, they tried that. In the Egyptian mummies, you know what they do? Along with the king, they bury. They bury wealth, they bury kitchen vessels. And then they bury what? Grains. Along with that they bury? Hundred slaves. 100 alive beings they will bury. Because who's going to serve the king there? Is the king going to cook his own food? You understand that? You can imagine all this will happen and you can do. But it's a loss making. It's a loss making business. The moment you understand this, you understand what you get? Detached. And when you are detached, you get interested in God. If you have to be interested in God, you have to be detached from the world. Full stop. You cannot have. To that mind, to that person, to that evolved soul, discussion on God. To that evolved soul, discussion on God. What is that God? Don't worry. Because God is that which cannot be described. So why waste time trying to talk about something that cannot be? Okay. It can't be described. Why talk the whole day? Leave that topic aside. But what you can understand is what? How your likes and dislikes find fulfillment, will find its fruition, but you remain the same. The entertainer of likes and dislikes remains the same. Likes and dislikes finds its fruition. You want a car, you get a car, but nothing changes you. You want a house, you get a house, but nothing changes in you. You want a job, you get a job, nothing changes in you. You want a family, you get a family, nothing changes in you. That man asked me, "Sir, in 70 years, what have I achieved?" In Mysore when I was living, that man asked me, 70 years I have lived, sir. What have I achieve. I said, how do I know? Only you should know what you have achieved. He is saying, four houses. He has four houses. Four houses. I was so tempted to say, engitta kuduthirumba adha. Next thing he said, I shut my mouth. Three children, I don't want them. Yeah, what will I do? Yeah. As it is, I am having problem with so many children at home. Yeah. Father, mother, on top of it I went and got married, wife, one more child, what I have to call as my, avula vechikitte problem, why bring one more? He is asking me, at the I have lived for 70 years, what have I achieved? Four houses, three children, and that three children I have produced another 20, that's all. I say, don't worry, in your obituary column you can put, yeah, when they put your photograph, they can put all the names, that's all your achievement is. What is the achievement? Nothing achieved. If you take the list of what all he has, done, blew up 80% of his money in charity. I'm not going into the details of what all he has. 80% of his income he has given up in charity. Everything, what all you can't even think of doing, that man has did. And then he is asking, what did I achieve? Because the discontentment is not going. The discontentment is not going. How to make him understand? How to make yourself understand? Yeah, that's the whole problem. How to make yourself understand this? What is it that you need to understand? The seed of discontentment. Any experience of discontentment, quickly cut it. Because every discontentment that you experience is, you don't understand that. Every discontentment that you experience and you promote it and you chase it and you nurture it and you nourish it is asking for more and more discontentment. More and more discontentment means more and more janmas. More and more janmas you ask for. And then when it is given to you, you say, what did I? Why is it like this, sir? No, what can you do? You asked for it, no. When you are asked for it, nature faithfully grants it to you. It grants it to you. Therefore, to know God is to know what discontentment is. To know God is to get rid of this discontentment. If you are so fired about knowing God, you have to do this. If you say, oh no sir, God allah namba apuram paathukalam sir, idella okay, elections la mudiyatum illaya, then we will see. Agni nakshatram la mudinjadhukku apuram, election la mudinjadhukku apuram, we will see God na what to do. We have to go back to the verses of chanting. All of them. We have to go back to the text and start chanting and do time pass. Chanting. Which verse we left, I don't remember. 27, 28 combined.
Kamsa bhikshasa kaunteya bhagavan bandhu navastitan kripaya paraya vishtah vishetam nidam abhradi arjuna uvacha drishte mam svajanam krishna yujutsum samupastitam sri विदन्ति मम गात्राणि मुखं च परिशुष्यति देवतुश्च शरीरे मे रोमहर्षश्च जायते.
Now what Arjuna, you remember, no? We are doing chapter one, then chapter one. The conscious was God alone. Utrungo. Now we have come to Gita. Please. Yes. I said, we know how to live life through, we know how to grow in life through discontentment. We do not know how to live life through contentment. Grow through contentment, not just live, to grow. We do not know that. How can you do that? Adanga agreela. Start with contentment means have the pride not to trade your action for a result. Have the pride. That's all. Have the pride in you that you will not be trading your action for a price. So, that is contentment. That is contentment. Don't trade yourself for a cash. Don't trade your action for at least that much pride you should have in your action. That is done with contentment. That's all. You follow what I'm saying? Don't go and sell yourself. All the CVs are nothing but selling. All the CVs, a fellow writes, no, resume. Till now I have never written a CV. I said, no, I will not. I don't want to sell. So ugly it is. So cheap it is to sell yourself. Now having sold yourself for 70 years, nothing matters. Don't worry. But at least understand what. At least from now on, do actions without this trading mentality. It means the starting point of action is contentment. Out of contentment, I don't know what all you spoke. Do that which you ought to do, I don't know what it is. Do without looking, do something without looking for the fruits, that also I don't know what it is. But one thing I know, what? How not to sell yourself for a price. You fix a price tag. You put a price tag upon yourself. That's all the price tag is. What is the price tag? Whatever be it. Doesn't matter whatever be it. Whatever be the price tag that you have put. What is the price tag? Doesn't mean only salary, yeah? Please. It doesn't mean only that. I want only my children to be happy. That's the price tag you have put it on yourself. And none of your children will be. They will be happy, but you will be unhappy. It's not that they will be unhappy. They will be happy or unhappy is in their hand. But you will remain. You will remain unhappy. You understand what is price tag? You follow? I hate to give examples, but the only way is to give examples. You follow? Don't put a price tag for your own actions. At least have that much what is it?
Pride.
At least that much pride have. That pride is allowed. Try it out. You will be suffocated because the mind will drive you to trade. Sell yourself. Don't sell yourself for a That's why the why is one face. That's why I give the example of the painter. Leonardo da Vinci wrote a letter to his friend. In that letter he says, why people have to ask me, why are you painting? Why are you painting? Why are you painting? If you were to be asked, you will give fantastic answers. What? He's a great artist. In that lies his Swadharma, correct? Yeah. That's half Vedanta Parsha, some answer like this. Yeah. Or he finds happiness only in that. He is a wonderful. In him, you go and ask him, he says there is no reason for painting except painting. You look at him and say, what a foolish man. Okay, at least paint and leave the paintings in my name, no? So that at least I can. Clear? That is our wisdom. That is our wisdom. Clear? At least give the copyrights to me, no? At least I know how to. These fellows know only, but they don't have that marketing thing, sir. They know how to make, but they don't know how to. They know how to sell it, huh? Wait, you go and sell yourself. That's where anybody who is into marketing, I get so irritated looking at them. Selling, constantly selling. You have sold your personality. You have sold your personality. In the Bible he says, you have sold the Jesus Christ for 30 pieces of silver. Where do you get a man like that? And that man is sold for 30 pieces of silver. No contentment. You understand? What is contentment now? How do you grow through contentment? First thing, you understand, life equals action. Inaction is death. You act. Why do you have to act? What is the reason for you to be in action? You are still alive, no? Still, as long as you are alive, you have to be in action. The only choice you have is either to do it sincerely or grudgingly, some problem. Either you do it sincerely or you do it grudgingly. That's all. But nevertheless, you can't get away from action. Might as well do it. So whatever you are doing, might as well do it sincerely. Why do you have to sell that action? Why do you have to have an attitude of trading, selling? Very cheap it is, no? Isn't it? It's very cheap to sell yourself for a price. Don't put a price tag. Simply keep acting. Don't put a price tag. But you have to put a. Why do you have to put a price tag? Why do you have to put a price tag? Discontentment. That price tag, getting that price, you have a hope that you can find fulfillment. You will get that price, but unfulfillment remains. Multiplies. Problem at the moment. It's unfulfillment. Unfulfillment multiplies. Therefore, what is to grow through contentment? First thing. Life equals action. You have to be in action. There is no other reason to act except the fact that you are alive. Therefore, as long as you are alive, you should be in action. Die with your boots on, Ramakrishna says. Die with your boots on. Walk into your own grave, he says. Even then, you do it by yourself. Don't force others to carry you. You walk into your own grave and lie down there, he says. That's the quality of living. That's the quality of action. Opposite of that is what? At least you will do funeral to me, no? And everybody is crying. What a affectionate thing, huh? You go and do your own. You go and bury. Ramtirtha says that. I am not saying, huh? He says, die with your boots on. Meaning, till the last minute of your life, you have to be in action. Since you have to be in action most constantly, most consistently, the only choice you have is what? Either to do it qualitatively, sincerely, or to do it? No, sir. What is it? Grudgingly, half-heartedly, yeah. Academy and the 11th one karma time, that's sir. Micha time all correct, all the 11th one karma time, they give work which we don't like. 2 hours you can't do, which someone asks you to do. Even there you want to do, what you? What can you do? Yeah, people tell me. You understand? Even there, that too, that task assigned to you, do it and leave it. Don't put a price tag. At least the price tag is, at least I should feel happy doing it, no? That's the price tag you have put. What is the price tag that you have put? Whatever I do, I should do it happily, no? Edu pannalum, we should do it happily, sir. Wholeheartedly. Do it sincerely. Put your heart and soul in that doing. Whatever you do, you put your heart and soul into it. And that's it. Now, you are contented. Just as the painter puts his heart and soul in the painting. In one of the exhibitions, they put a price tag for each and every painting. One of the painting fetched him $5 million. One painting fetched him $5 million. They went and told him that this painting, this man is willing to buy for $5 million. He was thinking, what is there in that painting that this man wants to buy it for $5 million? He rushed and he saw the painting. He screamed. It was hanging upside down. The painting was hanging upside down and the fellow wants to buy it for $5 million. He burnt all the paintings and he walked out. Literally he did that. He burnt all the paintings. He said, bring all the paintings and put it in the center. Lit a bonfire and what can you do? You understand? Putting a... You ask that fellow. He says, why do you paint? There is no reason to. This is what is known as growing through contentment. Other than the doing, there is no other reason for you to do anything. It means you are contented. You do it for any other purpose. Any other cause other than the mere doing it means you are discontent. You sow the seed of discontentment, you reap the tree of seed to seed. Na, it's okay. Yeah, you sow one seed and you reap a tree. Yeah, putai gota kuda nobody will take the tree. You single-handedly have to. Please understand that. You single-handedly, all alone, sitting in one corner, have to experience it. All by yourself you have to experience. Even if anyone wants to share it, they cannot share it. You have to do it all by yourself. You have to go through it all by yourself. Having understood this, the wise man says, enough of this samsara. Enough of this samsara. He refuses to identify with anything after that. This is what is known as growing through. Growth happens automatically because you are doing it sincerely. You are doing it wholeheartedly. Growth happens all by itself, and you are not interested in it. You are not interested in it, but growth happens. Why? Because the quality of your actions is such that action has to produce a result. And what will be the result? The result is prosperity. Hrishyate lakshmishya patniyau. Purusha Sukta. Wealth and prosperity comes and waits at your doorstep, waiting to attend on you. Wealth and prosperity comes. You don't have to do anything. Everything, everyone will be waiting to serve you. But then you quickly want to encash it. That's the right word, Venkata Subramanian. Correct as on Elningada. Wonderful is that word, encashing. How cheap it is to encash. After the talk, the whole world is an illusion, this, that and all that. And then after the class, I look at Venkat and say, Indamasana yola collection. How sickening it is, no? How cheap it is even to trade yourself for? Yeah. At least that much pride you should have. If at all one pride is allowed, na? This pride is allowed. Try it out. You will know how. If you try it out, you know how excruciatingly painful it is. But in that pain lies your salvation. In this pain lies your freedom. Therefore, I said, you grow out of contentment. Through contentment, your actions are sincere and qualitative. Sincere qualitative actions will produce what? Growth. Therefore, excuse me. Therefore, you grow out of contentment. Is it okay? Sariya? Encash. Parnavika. Mm-hmm.